Welcome to Sakhir and the Bahrain International Circuit, where the grid is forming up ready for today's race. Plenty of opportunities around the 3.36 miles of the Bahrain International Circuit for these young F2 drivers to show what they can do. The best passing opportunity right up there at turn one, and we should see plenty of action there. But there's another not long after at turn four. There are 9 right-handers and 6 left-handers, and the possibility that we could see some flat spots at the tightest of those left-handers, that's turn 10. We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. Harris lines up on pole position, and it's Robert Schwartzman in P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Joe, Phipps, Teo Pourchaire, and Drugovic, Sato, Nissany, Fittipaldi, Oscar Piastri, Zendeli, Lungard, Bent Fiskal, and Aitken, Boshon, Vachon, De Ruvola, and Marcus Armstrong, Beckman, Samaya, Lawson, and Alessio Deledda rounds off the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track. Davide, you're a 3-time winner around here in 1 week, I believe, back in 2012. How on earth do you make the tyres last around this track? They degrade so quickly.
To be honest, the key to the race is having a good start so you can get your car into a good position. Then save the tyres as much as you can and push just at the end.
Pole position. Let's go for the win, mate. Okay, that's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining, 5 laps of fuel left. No tyre concerns at the moment, just focus on the driving. Okay, no issues with tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of them. No threat of rain for the time being. Conditions look good. Work, mate, that brings you up a place. Okay, this is your final lap of the race. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 9.6 seconds. fantastic drive. That's just fantastic. Amazing. You deserve that race win. Well done, mate.
Carlin have pulled off a sublime performance to secure the top step of the podium today.
Davide, what do you think made the difference here?
Although the Formula 2 cars are all the same spec, the winner just looked better out there. It would have been a combination of getting those tires up to running temperature faster and driving to the condition on track. They made it look easy out there today.
And there you have it, today's winners. Having raised some of the biggest names in F1 to date, Carlin have once again shown their expertise when it comes to recruiting new talent. No doubt today's winners have a bright future ahead of them. They certainly deserve it after today's performance. And now, let's take a look at the driver's standings.
Harris increases their championship lead.
And now, Davide Valsecchi, let me ask you, who is your driver of the day?
I'm going to say Jake Aitken. It was probably one of his best drivers of the season, and I was impressed.
On to the teams then. Carlin moved to the top of the table. After all this drama, you'll be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care.
So qualifying is complete and we're all set for an exciting race tomorrow. Your top three are
Joe
Armstrong
and Teo Pourchaire.
With qualifying complete, all that remains is the main event. We'll be live and uninterrupted for the feature race tomorrow, so make sure you join us then.
It's Sunday, and that means it's race time here at Silverstone. As the cars are being prepared, let's join them trackside for the start of the race. So Silverstone's 3.6 miles of tarmac and 18 corners are no stranger to rain. Even in these conditions, without the DRS that would normally be available, the Wellington and Hanger Straits still represent some of the best opportunities for overtaking. So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's results with a look at the starting grid.
Guan Yu Zhou lines up on pole position,
and it's Marcus Armstrong in P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Pourchaire, Drugovich. I'm joined by a man who's had many a wet race, Davide Valsecchi. Just how challenging will these conditions be out there on track?
Delighted to be here, Alex. Even in this weather, nothing will be easy for them. We may have standing water, which means visibility will be a worry. They just need to stay clear of the white lines and curbs. That can cause you a real problem when it's so slippery.
I know this is your home Grand Prix, but treat it like any other race. Let's not make any unnecessary risks.
Thank you.
Okay, focus. We need to stay on form. Okay, this is your final lap of the race. OK, Bosheng ahead. OK, gaps of the car ahead is 9.0 seconds. They're on a fresh set of wets. Time last lap was a 1:58.8. OK, mate, this is not good. You're losing 3 seconds a lap. Okay, pick up rubber and bring it home.
So Virtuosi have won it, and what a great race it was.
Tell me, Davide, what was the key to this success?
Their biggest advantage was how well they seemed to manage their tire temper. There wasn't a lot of grip out there anyway, but it was even worse for the drivers if they couldn't keep the tires in the proper operating window. Keeping the tires warm was what gave them the advantage today, and ultimately was a big factor in their win.
And here are podium drivers today after that excellent race. They've excelled here as they so often do, and it's a well-deserved victory. Virtuosi then are on top today. Guan Yu Zhou takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship after that excellent result. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. And so, driver of the day then, Davide Valsecchi, who do you think you'd go for?
Look at Guan Yu. It was fantastic all race long, and he showed me a great talent and fantastic quality. It's for that that he is my driver of the day.
And now a look at the team standings. Virtuosi moved to the top of the table. Another team that excelled today was Dams, who make further progress up the table. After all this drama, you'll be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care.